Inside the Garden. He talked with some fans tonight. Adam, what's going on down there?
Well, Tom, it was a pretty interesting scene here earlier in the evening. You had fans filing into the game, and as always, there's trash talk going on both sides. But what was unique about tonight is that you had trash talk going on in English and in French.
Oui, cher! Oui, cher, oui, cher!
It's a rivalry with an international flavor. As the Bruins faithful filed into the Garden Thursday, they were joined by fans of the Montreal Canadiens and their unique customs.
We are Canadian rail fans. Boston Bruins are not rail fans. We are.
We have a positive attitude.
Yeah, we are positive.
Negative attitude. That's the thing.
Some might say what's lost in translation is Boston's toughness.
They love to hit, they love to check, they love to fight, and that's the old school Bruins. And then you have the Canadians, which have always been sort of a speed and finesse team, and that's really where the differences are. You have two different styles, two different approaches to the game, and it's fun.
It is fun, in a bare-knuckled, bloody kind of way.
We've encountered him 34 times in the course of history. There are 11 teams in the NHL that have not played as many playoff series as we have played against the Montreal Canadiens. This hatred goes way back, and honestly, it's like the Red Sox-Yankees rivalry, but with a violent sport.
Not all wearing the red, white, and blue tonight are speaking French. TJ McDonald bears the burden of being a Boston-based Habs fan.
You put up with a lot of abuse in your life, I'm sure.
A lot. I mean, I went to high school here, like I'm from here, always Canadiens fan. It's never a good time. You deal with it.
At the moment, being a friend to TJ is not easy.
It brings me down a little bit. People see me next to him, it ruins me. It hurts a little bit on the inside. I don't know. It ain't nice though.
All right, fans we spoke to on both sides of the fence here agree this is going to be a long series, at least 6 or 7 games, with a few overtime games peppered in there. Looked like we were headed in that direction just a few minutes ago, but obviously with Montreal's goal, the Bruins are going to need at least one to tie it up and send it to overtime. Reporting live in Boston, Adam Sexton, WMUR News.